All right. Let me turn on my lights real quick. And booyah. Man, I can't wait till I get that hung up. I have been busier than a one-legged man in a butt-kicking contest today. And it's driving me crazy. I got 19 minutes for the next, our Vendors United. We do a private show every Monday night. And that starts in 19 minutes. So I got to hurry with this. I got a question from a vendor. Let me flip this over real quick. He asked, where is it? Do you know of anyone who uses their cart to sell? I never know how to pronounce this. Gyros, but I heard it's Gyros. I could be wrong. It could be Hero. I don't know. If so, how would this differ from just offering hot dogs? Well, here's the thing. Why wouldn't I just call the cart something different other than why does everybody call them hot dog carts? The reason why is hot dogs are legal in all 50 states. There are a ton of things you could do. I've done from my cart, okay? Barbecue, pulled pork. I've done riblets. I've done corn on the cob. I've done loaded baked potatoes. So I take a baked potato. I already have them pre-cooked, put them in the cart, keep them hot. And then I have all the sides, the sauces, the cheese, the sour cream. I even used the sour cream gun. You can go look at it. It's on the blog. And I made loaded baked potatoes for an event. Now, here's the thing, though. Most states don't allow all these other foods on street vending or vending like in front of the Piggly Wiggly or vending in front of Tractor Supply. They don't allow certain foods because they consider some foods potentially hazardous, which means they have a higher rate of possible or a smaller window of temperature before bacteria grows, and they don't want an open cart serving that. You get an enclosed trailer or a food truck, okay? And now you can serve anything you want. Because it's enclosed, but they limit vendors to certain foods, non-potentially hazardous foods. Now, hot dogs legal in all 50 states. Pre-cooked sausages, legal in all 50 states. So those things we know, but there are vendors doing now, right now, soups from their cart. Some states allow it. Some states allow you to do the corn on the cob, the barbecue, the pulled pork, the pastas. I've done on my cart, pasta, like shrimp Alfredo, spaghetti. Spaghetti's a popular one. I've done more spaghetti like a catering thing. So yes, you can do tons of things from your cart. Okay, tons. You can do all kinds of things, but that doesn't mean you can do them by the state code. So always check with your state codes first. Well, who do you call for that? How do you know? You start Googling. Here's what the easiest way to do this. Call the health department. Even if you don't know who to talk to, say, who handles the restaurant inspections? And if you're in a big city, they'll go, what part of the city? And then you say, make up a part of the city. Okay. And they'll go, oh, that's Bob. And you go, okay, can I talk to Bob? Well, he's not in right now, but you can leave him a message. You leave him a message, or you get it. You're lucky and you get a hold of Bob, and you say, Bob, I'm thinking about opening a food cart that's not enclosed. It kind of looks like a hot dog cart, but it's set up like a restaurant, has running water, hot and cold, everything. What foods am I legally allowed to serve? And he can tell you. He'll tell you, oh, you can serve this, you can serve that, you can serve this other. Because some aren't restricted. Like me, I was restricted from serving meat in chili, all beef in chili, but I can serve an all beef hot dog. Both are pre-cooked, and that's what makes it safe, is because it's pre-cooked, but yet in chili, no, I wasn't allowed to. That's a whole nother ball game. Don't even know why that exists, but that's the way it is in Tennessee. Now, you go to a different part of Tennessee. It's not that they have different codes. They have inspectors that are a lot more lenient and a lot more realistic. And they'll go, oh, you want to do cheese? Sure, go ahead and do cheese. Just keep it at the right temp. I wasn't allowed to do cheese. I had to use Cheese Whiz. It's like 99% Whiz and 1% cheese out of a squirt can. Anyway, so that's what I did. I made always made a way around it. Like the chili, I got Chili Man's chili. I got the vegetarian one. And the vegetarian one tasted just like the meat one. And it won 3 world records for it. And so we've got vendors that use that in states that don't allow it, meated chili. So I asked my inspector a long time ago, I said, so what if I cut up my hot dogs all beef and put them in the chili? Oh, you can do that. So I can't take regular all beef, pre-cooked chili and serve. It just didn't make sense. You see where I'm going with this. I'll go on a tangent here in a second with that. So the bottom line is yes. And there's many things you can serve. Many, many, many things you can serve. Check first, find out what you can and find out what the loopholes are. Guess what? In some states like North Carolina, you can be a caterer as long as you prepare it and serve it at that event. You can serve anything you want. Anything you want. Doesn't matter. So different states have different rules. Oh, and guess what else? You don't even have to have a license in North Carolina to be a caterer. So you can just be a caterer and serve stuff at their house. You can go out there and cook a whole hog. I did it. Okay? And no license required other than your business license, but no health department license. So I just wanted to let you know that. I hope that helped, Redman. That question was from Redman. Let's see. Eric Vaughn Dumb has posted. Let's see. I want to read some of this. Well, my son was about 2 hours cars. You're a godsend. I want to give these kids the same memories I had growing up in Chicago. The smells of the hot dog cart, the guy in the apron, and the bellowing laugh, the steam flowing out the sides, and feeling actually being allowed to pick my own toppings and being treated like a customer and not a child. Priceless. Love it. Eric, that is freaking awesome. I'm going to respond to you later on here as well, but just so you know, he said, also said in Marine boot camp, our drill instructors would ask if we wanted to be good Marines or dead Marines, then proceed to kick our ass if for some screw up we did. I'm still alive and you're helping the vendors to stay alive. Keep doing what you're doing. Thank you, Eric. I appreciate that. He was responding to a video. I don't know the name of it, how you're something. I don't know. Anyway, do you, I'm going through these real quick. I just don't want to miss anybody. I love the fact, oh, did y'all see the freaking, this made my day. Did y'all see the interview that I posted it today? Castro Dogs, a freaking phenomenal vendor and family. He's teaching his kids the value of work and the responsibility. I even put pictures up on the site. If you want that, I'm going to give you that real quick. I made a blog article so I could share the rest of the pictures and everything with you. And so I want to share that on here as well. Let me put that on here. There you go. There's that link. That is Castro Dogs. Check that out. Look at what he did already in 7 days. 7 days. He started 7 days ago. Okay. And not with, oh, he had a lot of money and this was just always a dream and a hobby thing. No, he couldn't work for the last 7 years because nobody'd hire him. The guy is phenomenal. He's got an awesome wife. Kids are cool. He just, you can tell, just freaking feels good. It hit me in the feels. I can tell you that. Anyway, Nick Dye says, I'm glad you're doing this episode, working on my menu for the summer. Hey, Nick, type in menu at learnhotdogs.com if you want more. I'm running through this fast. There's so much you can do. So much you can do. You have a mobile kitchen, a mini mobile kitchen. So it's the options are unlimited. Hey, Ben, you're a treasure trove of information. Thank you, busy boy. Justin Fox says, hey, Ben, love your videos. Thanks for all the help. I've gotten a question. Is the normal health department to be able to find you if you mess up? Example, not keeping your food up to temperature, etc. No. Go to any restaurant. Look at their report card. You know, they post it up, their grade, and you'll see 87, 82, 91, whatever. That's because they messed up somewhere. They don't get a fine for that. When you get a fine and it's, some states don't fine you, but some states do. But the ones that when they fine you, it's after they've warned you or it's a blatant thing. Like, let's say you blatantly were serving moldy cheese. Okay. They could fine you. They could shut you down immediately, which they should. But so fines are, I've never heard of a vendor getting fined, a hot dog vendor that I've talked with. No one ever. Vendors that I work with, though, I have to say, are clean and they do things by the books. Can you mess up? Yes, we all do. But we usually catch it before any health inspector is going to catch it. Now, a health inspector may come out and go, oh, I see a crack in your bread box. Bugs can get into your bread box. Well, they'd have to be Houdini to get into the bag, which is in another container, to get to the bread. Doesn't matter. I want that caulked up. Okay, I'll caulk it up. He marked you off a little on your next thing, and you're done. It's no big deal. Lotto Vegas. Hey, Ben. Hey, Lotto Vegas. Dragon Winners Catering. Yes, a similar story here. Exactly. Dragon Winners. So proud of him, Ben. I am too, Amanda. I freaking love the fact that he just owned this shit. He said, I'm going to tell people. I'm going to be me. And freak, I couldn't believe that. Just awesome. And I have another interview coming, okay? I just ain't finished. It's already done. The interview's done. And I'm going to put it in the email. If you're not on my email list, get on my freaking email list. I don't bombard you. Go to learnhotdogs.com, top right corner, click the little email-y thing. Okay, just went to Legion to ask them about the commissary, told them I only need to rent out 2 shelves. They want to know how much I'll pay them a month to make it worth it. What should I offer? Good question, Kristen. And I got to go after this. I swear I got to go. Okay, here's the deal. If you're, if Kristen, if here's what I would do. I don't know how you pitched it. I hope you pitched it like I teach to pitch it, which is, like, hey, we're small, we're just getting started, we have to have a commissary. But either way, you have an opportunity here. Here's one I'd do. I'd go, well, we were thinking that because we're just getting started out and we don't know how long we'll really need it, I hate to commit to something and then fail y'all. Do y'all do events? What if I let you use my cart and I came out and cooked for you? And they may go, oh, that's a great idea. We do a fundraiser in October. We'd love to have you. And then they'll go back and tell all their people at the Legion that you are going to be doing their fundraiser thing with them. So there's ways to do it. Now, what could you pay? It's up to you. Okay. I've got vendors that charge other vendors $250 to use their commissary a month. Some charge $500 a month to use their commissary. So offer them, if you have to feel like you got to offer them something other than what I just told you, maybe $50 a month. That'd be cheap, okay, to use their commissary. And they're going to let you use shelves. That's kind of cool. You get to use some space. I would do that. And then I believe that if you will be generous to them, I have a rule. Give before payments given. Give. If you give in life, good stuff just keeps happening. Doesn't mean bad stuff doesn't happen. I get lots of bad stuff. I can tell you stories that make you cry. And you've probably got some to tell me, but don't tell me because I don't like crying. So the bottom line is give to them. Do something nice for them. When you go in there, if you're paying them monthly, just start doing a little extra. Hey, guys, I did an event. I got 50 hot dogs left over. Even if you didn't, you made them 50 hot dogs and you brought them to them. And give them to them. Do some cool things like that and you'll endear yourself. And plus you're just being a good citizen and a good human being. And I like being good human beings. Randall Brandon says, the best thing about Monday is Ben Wilson. I wish my kids felt the same way. I'm just kidding. They do now. Most of them are all adults except for one, and he's 17 almost. And so most of them, they appreciate you now more than they did when they were 16 and 15 and 8. Kristen, let me know how that goes. I want to know. Okay. I don't give out this stuff and you think that I don't think about it later. I think about it. I even think a better answer sometimes later, and then I'll do a blog article. So I love y'all. I hope you have a freaking fantastic evening. I got to go. I got 4 minutes. All right. I'll see y'all.